I'm going to try to murder them and hope their armor keeps them alive. Like, I'm not holding back. I am literally out there hunting you. And, like, my goal when the helm goes on is to do as much damage as I can.
This is Armored Combat, where modern-day knights fight for glory, not so much in an ancient battlefield, but a family campground, where hand-forged, historically accurate weaponry and armor protect them, but don't think about calling it LARPing. On the other hand, it is self-proclaimed nerds who dress up and beat each other with swords.
No, I don't have to worry about people going, well, you're a damn nerd. I'm like, I couldn't have cared less when they said it before, but I'm like, well, the nerdy things I do are pretty intense, so yeah. You can fuck off.
It's absolute chaos. Madness. Do I know what's going on? Absolutely not. Great takedown. And in a twist I did not see coming, polyamory, alive and well in the community.
There is no having to, like, hide anything. And it's like, yes, I am making out with both of these guys in succession, and also that girl. Like, everything's fine.
So I charge headfirst into armored combat to show you the people and stories of this port. Walker, I'm feeling slightly like maybe we've bitten off more than we can chew. I was sort of promised.
Ready? Are you ready? Start fighting.
Right. Well, before we get into all of that, we need to start at level 1 of this hero's quest and find out who these Knights of Nerdalot really are. I met Chris at his home so he could walk me through this gauntlet of medieval badassery.
We are the Portland Reavers. That is our chapter of Armored Combat Sports. There's chapters all across the country. In New England, we've got the Nashua Nightmares, Manchester Monarchs, New Haven Highlanders, and the Boston Dark Knights. And then we're the newest team, and we're still kind of growing and getting ourselves together.
I imagine if somebody broke into the house, you could do something like, if you could just, like, wait, I need to pick, like, hold on 1 second, let me pick, should I do it with this sword, should I do it with a battle
axe? Maybe the pole axe.
Yeah. Not a lot of room in the house for one of these.
Right, so you probably would want to go with the falchion.
And right off the bat, like, the first thing that I'm thinking with Peace and Love, of course, is, like, when I'm trying to get my mind around this thing, it's like this crazy, just, like, thing of, it's kind of like a nerdy sort of geek thing, but also, like, a badass smash each other's brains in. And, like, every time I'm like, what is this? I'm like, is it kind of like LARPing, or is it MMA? Is it combination?
Well, it's like nerd sport. Yeah. We in Armored Combat Sports, we're definitely more sport-focused. You know, there's all the history behind it. We are actually doing reenactment of a 14th or 15th century tournament.
The emotion, I'm sure, is like you feel alive.
It's a feeling that you can't get most places because you're allowing yourself to just let go and fight. And, you know, you're assuming this potential risk of getting just blasted. But when you're in that moment, you do feel alive. And afterwards, when you're exhausted, it feels like you really accomplished something.
And what kind of host would I be if I didn't try and get into the helmets of these knights and feel the pain and exhilaration of getting hit in the head with a sword, and also be ready for flying cows that could be catapulted from Frenchmen at any second? Not a good one. I think that was rhetorical, but I answered it anyways.
You know, for the sake of science and to really figure out what the sport is all about, I'm sacrificing my body as, you know, a noble pursuit of learning and knowledge.
Science.
And letting the real knight, you know, blast away on my head, I suppose. Visibility is small, which I feel like is a good thing, because I don't know if I want to watch the sword coming to hit me in the fucking head. Go when you're ready, I guess.
When you're ready. All right. Oh.
The fist is definitely, maybe worse.
It can be.
You do sort of expect it to be much worse than it is, but it's kind of awesome. And, like, I've got, like, a fucking night boner right now, dude. I'm feeling alive right now.
Was that too much information? Perhaps over the line? Well, I apologize. I'm all hopped up on brain injuries and ready to slay a fucking dragon. Luckily, practice was a short walk to the next street over, where we met the entire team training for Valhalla. Not like the Nordic afterlife, but a tournament happening next week.
Were you super athletic and like into sports and shit when you were young?
No, I did like long distance track and field in seventh grade. Otherwise, I haven't done a real sport.
Do you feel
at all.
Like that happens a lot with this sport? Like people who aren't like your typical
quite
athletes?
Often, yeah.
What
quite
do you think
often.
That is? What's the pull?
I think it's the nerd. Just the nerd aspect of it.
It does seem like there's that sort of extra accoutrement of like medieval shit, swords, fucking fan, you know what I mean? I feel like we should be listening to like Dragon Force right now, like getting bumped up to do it, you know?
All right, it's time to step off the sidelines, gear up, and go to battle. Saving the suit of arms for the big tournament days, practices are fought in padded armor and weapons known as a soft kit. Time to roll the 20-sided die and hope for a sweet-ass melee attack. Also, it just occurred to me that I don't really know the rules, so I'm just gonna hit him with a pointy bit and hope for the best.
Good combo.
What? What? What was that? I think I just made up a new move.
Yes!
There you go.
Perfect.
Hey, you're natural.
I retire. That's it. I retire. I'm done.
Yeah.
Can you get Zach in the picture? Because I just want you to know, get Zach in here too while he's working the camera. Hey, Arlo, cameraman, he loves to talk shit. What do you gotta say now, Zach, if you saw me with that sword? What are you gonna say now, Zach?
That's what I thought.
To Valhalla.
To Valhalla. To the gods. Men, to bed. For tomorrow, we rise. To Valhalla. For strength. For honor. For pride.
Let's just hope Steve Coogan doesn't watch this show. Anyways, this is Valhalla. Again, not that Valhalla, but a campground in the mountains of New Hampshire where they hold a medieval tournament with people from all over the country coming to gear up and geek out on all things armored combat. 4 days of not only fighting, but a time where like-minded outcasts come together to celebrate their unique interests, from historically accurate weaponry, high fantasy novels, and, you know, multiple sexual partners. That's right, we'll get into that in a little bit. But for some, this is more than just a game. The acceptance of all lifestyles and personality types crosses over from just a sport to a community. And for many, was life-changing and even life-saving.
I'm Ringo, and I fight in armored combat sports because before I found it, every day on my drive to work at a specific spot, I was like, I should just take the car off the road. Every day. And about 6 months after I started fighting, I stopped thinking like that.
I mean, so in terms of the community that is in this sport, and particularly the one that the little corner of it that I have become really like deeply a part of, like these are some of the best friends that I have had my whole life, really.
I lost, what, 80 or 90 pounds?
Probably, yeah.
Yeah, I lost 80 or 90 pounds just training. Changed my life, changed my attitude, changed my friends.
It's not just about how you can do it to others, right? It's also about how about getting it done to you. Can you handle getting your shit pounded, right? Am I tough enough to put up with the abuse that's raining in on me, which, if I wasn't wearing this armor, is absolutely fucking lethal.
And then there's the barbarian. I could try and explain to you exactly who he is, but I think these clips do much better justice. He's got a certain charm.
Fight. We're not going out there to like break people or do anything heinous. It's gonna be fun. I'm jazzed up. Adrenaline is the best drug in the world. And I'm ready to punch people. Okay, get the fuck out of here.
Okay, I'm out of here. Okay, all right, bye.
Inside this helmet, you're gonna have the immediate panic. Like once you get out of breath, you're gonna have a helmet horror moment. You're gonna be like, get the fucking helmet off of me.
Yeah.
We're just gonna open the visor and you're gonna keep the helmet on because you're okay.
Right,
you're not gonna die unless you stab somebody and then we'll probably take you out back.
Yeah.
Can you do? Put your thumb if you know.
Oh. Did that hurt? Did I hurt you?
How's the chest? Can you take a deep breath? Yep. Do you feel restricted?
After the punch to the chest, I feel slightly out of
breath. Oh, you'll be fine!
Fun guy. Another unique layer to this sport is the prevalence of polyamory, the act of multiple partners. So I sat down with some of the members to talk about why it's such a popular lifestyle in armored combat.
You've got a husband, but you two are also together.
Yes.
Husband, obviously aware. It's all above board. We're all into it. And then you have also another partner as well.
I have
another girlfriend, and we're kind of seeing each other. We haven't really formalized it, but
we're that's news to me. We're discovering this all together right now. Okay.
One of the things that I think is really helpful in this community as a whole is that there are so many poly couples and people that like, and it's so commonplace that like there is no having to like hide anything, and it's like, yes, I am making out with both of these guys in succession, and also that girl, like everything's fine.
But it's also just full of outsiders, like punks, weird Quaker people, like anyone who's just like, who society didn't work for, you tend to go to the out, and then when you're on the outside, you find other people on the outside. And so you just might find poly people because you're hanging out in a circle around other outside people. And now, even if it wasn't a thing that called to you before, you're like, well, maybe I'll try it.
And that nerd circle, I think, is where the polyamory comes from. It's like, okay, this normal monogamy stuff doesn't make sense because most of normal society doesn't make sense. So what if we did it this way instead? And now you have all the polyamorous team, like nerds in sword fighting.
Back to the action, and Chris is ready for his first big melee 5-on-5 battle ever, and we've got special VIP access to the team, and by that I mean I just kind of walked up and had the camera crew there.
So, Rage of Cajun, starting lineup, left to right. I'm gonna be on the left rail.
Okay.
Joe is gonna be my number two. Okay. Xander's is in the three spot. Gavin's the guard on the right. Wilkins, your rail on the right.
All right, we're gonna set the line.
All right, we're not gonna go past halfway. We don't wanna overextend our line. Xander, you're gonna make the call. When you think we're too far out, you're just gonna say hold, all right?
What's the vibe right now?
Oh, it's did you play football back in the day?
Yes. Like,
you know, butterflies before kickoff, and then once you get that first hit out of the way, you're good?
Yes.
That's exactly what this is.
Every fight.
Every fight.
And you always have to piss right before the fight. You have to get all your armor on.
There's at least three pre-fight pisses, and two of them usually come after you're already armored up.
Yeah, which basically means they don't have you.
Right. Yeah.
Unless you get hit hard enough.
I've not yet had that happen yet.
We're not that old yet. We're getting there, though.
All right, battle time. Chris does a last-minute equipment check, make sure all the Lord's men are safe and snug. This is a 5-versus-5 melee, meaning if you hit the ground, you're out. The team with the last and most men standing wins. Chris sizes up his opponent. Cheeky little shot to the head there, not a lot of damage, bit of a whiff. And then they seem to all hug each other because, you know, it's an emotional thing and you want support. Down he goes. Chris is out. That's okay. Next round, we regroup, starting off strong with a nice teep. Another nice heap, but while getting hit in the face with an axe, a huge hit to the head. That's probably gonna cause some sort of damage in the future. Into the corner, and I see a pattern coming. Down on the ground he goes. This guy's gonna murder him, apparently. Paralyze him forever. No, just a hit to the shoulder. And another axe choke. Fatigue starting to set in now. Probably best just to lay down here for a while. Yeah, take a quick, just a quick little napper. And finally, Chris in a scrum here, and then it's gonna get smashed with a huge hit, and then those two guys start fighting. We're just gonna lay here for a while, you know, think about our life choices and just relax.
Come,
talk to me. How are we feeling?
Oh, sweaty already.
Yeah, tired?
Yeah. Okay, it's a tough first fight, because these are like the best in the region, and then some best from other regions.
Yeah.
And there was one point where he was on me, and then I saw Cat move around me, and I was trying to get him as well, because if I'm tied up, I might as well try and tie up two people.
Yeah,
that didn't work out.
See, now this is what separates us from the competition. I'm over here all hopped up on medieval mania, and getting ready to get suited up, jump in the ring, and have a sword fight with another man. Quick gear test to make sure I don't get beheaded.
Ready for battle.
Here you go, Faustian.
To war.
No. Well, are you left-handed or right-handed?
I'm right-handed.
Okay, there you go. Give him a shield.
Are you this gentle with everybody?
Turn it around backwards. The big pointy part?
Yeah.
That's actually how you
do my going. I can't see
armor.
In this goddamn thing.
How can you not see? There's eye holes right there. There's tons of them.
Now, I will say, for a bunch of adults running around in medieval armor and dueling, they get pretty sensitive when you try to make a joke about it. This is very serious business and no funny stuff.
One, can you knight me?
No.
What?
Don't make what the fuck I've been doing for the last 7 years.
Okay, right,
stupid
all right, all right, all right.
It's a sport, you cuck.
You can knight 5-year-olds. I knight 5-year-olds.
We've knighted 5-year-olds. But...
You can knight 5-year-olds.
Okay.
You have to fight once before you get knighted. Okay.
30 years.
I agree with that. I was just asking. I'm not allowed to ask questions around here.
Nope.
Apparently, I'm supposed to be in a whole ass suit of metal armor, looking like the cast of Game of Thrones, and not want to be King of the North.
Surprised I wasn't put in the Iron Maiden. Tyranny, I say, tyranny. After being verbally abused by my coach, it was time to be physically beaten with a sword, kinky, and with no idea what I'm doing or the rules of the sport, it was trial by fire, cue the shredding fantasy guitar solo.
See, so then I kind of just sort of wildly.
That's kind of what you do. You kind of started doing that.
How was the kicking?
It was actually good. I wouldn't do the side kicks. Don't do nearly as much. You do them.
As the teep.
If you do the teep, it'll be a lot better.
Okay, takedown was good. That worked.
Yeah. Did kick him straight in the dick, though.
I did. Don't fight. My bad, Ringo.
Start fight. 1 minute.
Technically, I went medieval on his ass.
You did, actually. Yeah. I think you gave him a run for his money.
God, that's all I wanted. Thanks.
Hit him with a spin. Locked in. Lock, lock, lock. Now, I call that the Tegan Tornado. Trademark move. That's mine.
Well, it's time to sheath our swords and victoriously exit the world of armored combat. I think it's clear from the stories of everyone involved here that this is a great community for anyone looking to exercise their nerd and competitive muscles, as well as a place to meet friends and that special someone, or in this case, that special several people. As a bit of a fantasy nerd myself, I loved it, but if I'm gonna dress up as a knight, personally, I'm gonna have a little fun with it. So, one last horse ride into the field of battle and on to the next oddball adventure, because they can take our lives, but they can never take our freedom. Good night.